All right, welcome back to Currency 365. It is October 1st, 2018. Hope you guys are doing well. Like the video, subscribe, and share. Thank you guys for watching the videos. Canada, America, and Mexico looks like they have reached some type of trade deal. So let's check it out. It says Canadian dollars near vertical rally continues as U.S.-Canada reach trade deal. Okay, it says what started last week as a data an OPEC-driven rally has become something of a rout, with the Canadian dollar battering other currencies against again on Monday, following news that Canada and the United States, together with Mexico, have finally agreed on a trade deal. Okay, so let's see here. Says Canadian dollar is soaring following the news that Canada and United States, together with Mexico, have agreed on a trade deal. Today, Canada and the United States reach an agreement along with Mexico on a new modernized trade agreement for the 21st century, the United States-Mexico-Canada Agreement, the USMCA, U.S. Trade Representative Robert, and also the Canadian Foreign Minister said in a joint statement. Okay. The USMCA will give our workers, farmers, ranchers, and businesses a high standard trade agreement that will result in freer markets, fairer trade, and robust economic growth in our region. It will strengthen the middle class and create good, well-paying jobs for the nearly half a billion people who call North America home. All right. As you can see, guys, here that the European currency against the Canadian dollar is coming down. So Canadian dollar is getting stronger, okay, against the euro because of the news as well. So Canada's been rallying. Deutsche Bank also made the I made the video about Deutsche Bank saying that Canadian dollar, Mexico, the Mexican peso, and the euro would be currencies that benefit off of the China and America trade wars, and Canada has been absolutely going up. So there it is. Okay, let's check out the markets. The Dow Jones is up 26,665. S&P 500 up. NASDAQ is down. Global Dow is up. Gold is down. It's at 1,193. And oil is at 75, making its way to 80. And then it'll make its way to 90. Some people are calling for $100 within the next 6 to 12 months. The U.S. dollar is at 95.27. Very strong. Okay, so that's it. Talk to you.
Welcome to Divine Intel. Bienvenidos a Intel Divino. Este show será bilingüe, así que esperan que yo vaya a traducir. Ya saben cómo trabaja este formato. No es fácil. A lo mejor me vaya a saltar de la información. Tú estás en todo tu derecho a quejarte. Quéjate, voy a estar viendo tus textos y yo voy a regresar y repetirte lo que me salté. ¿Entendido? Okay, I just said that this is a bilingual show, Spanish English or English Spanish, and everybody has the right to complain. Yes, you have the right to complain because you're my audience, right? So if you believe that I skip something, if you believe that are you missing information, please let me know with your text. Let me know with your test. I'm not going to block you. I'm not going to complain. As a matter of fact, I want you to be informed. All right? So, this is Divine Intel. Welcome. We are going to put all the pieces together in a way that you've never seen before. And once again, we were right again. And I also have a... I just answer something in a very rude way to somebody. I'm going to tell you who that person is. I'm not going to mention her name because it's a lady, I believe. But the reason why I jump up into this approach, it has a lot of sense. Because you have no idea what's coming. They're going to try to get us. They are going to try to get us. People believe that, you know, the information that I'm giving is pretty pure entertainment, which it is. It is pure entertainment. But because of entertainment, I gotta give you that, right? Hint, right? So I will let you know what it is. What I got. We're gonna go to some beautiful news, some beautiful announcement, and why we probably have seen the reset within the United States, and why is not the way you thought it was going to be. It was never meant to be the way you thought it was going to be. The gurus have been lying to you. All of them have been lying to you into thinking that there will be some moron up there in either in Iraq or Donald Trump all of a sudden said, oh, this is the reset. Everybody, God is changed. That's what they will make you believe. And I told you there will be no reset. There will be no announcement. There will be a reset, but there will be no announcement. Not the way that you thought. And once again, I was right. I will play the video. I'm going to let you know. So now let me go back to Spanish. El show se llama El Anuncio, y por qué este podría ser el reseteo, es la pregunta. Te voy a demostrar una vez más que todos los gurús te han engañado. Te voy a demostrar una vez más que lo que te dijeron fue una mentira. Porque si yo te voy a introducir la verdad, yo tengo que matar el mentiroso. Yo tengo que asesinar la mentira. Por tanto tiempo te han dicho que iba a haber un anuncio, como un idiota que iba a salir, mira, este es el reseteo, este es el Arbi, vayan y cambian. Esto no va a pasar. Esto no pasó y esto no va a pasar así. Solamente los gurús se la llevan que saben todo y no saben ni mierda. Por eso te voy a dar con la mejor manera que yo te voy a explicar, porque tú estás engañado y tienes que aprender. Porque todo lo que te estoy diciendo está saliendo, a menos que tú eres completo zombie y no quieras entenderlo. Pero como tú sabes, yo no soy tu papi, tú puedes hacer lo que tú quieras. All right, so I'm gonna call my pastor. Oh, by the way, I have a special guest. Yes, I have a special guest. And he's from Puerto Rico. He shares some beautiful recording of a prophet in Puerto Rico. And he mentioned something so beautiful. I was astonished. So I'm going to bring him to my show. I'm going to call him. We're going to have a nice chat in Spanish. And I'm going to explain to you what he said. And I want you to pick up your Bibles, please. I need you to grab your Bibles if you have one. And I want you to read as he tells you what to read. Please, do me that favor. Because he's going to read it in Spanish, or the recording is going to read it in Spanish. And I want you to read it for yourself in English. Okay? We're all going to learn something. God is speaking. Only the deaf don't want to hear the truth. Only the blind don't want to see the truth. And only the retards will go to gurus. That's the truth. I'm sorry. There's no other way. You cannot have it. Listen, in life, you either have one way or another. Can we agree with that? Right? Okay. So, again, like I told you, I got a sister. Probably she's a Christian, I don't know what she is. And she asked me to help her, and I insult her. Why? Because you either have a one way or you have another way. It's very simple, right? Because Marilyn, you know, she's looking for my information. She found it very entertaining. That's fine. That's fine. But if I want to make a point, I need to wake you up, don't I? Right, sister? You know who you are. I want to tell you publicly, I'm going to read everything I type in my private message with you. I'm going to read everything. If you think that I'm not going to read everything just because it was private, you got it wrong. I'm going to read everything you wrote, and I'm going to read everything I wrote. And I'm going to let you know why I was so rude with you. So be ready. If you don't want to be insulted, I'm not going to insult you. I already did. Trust me, I'm not going to insult you. I'm going to wake you up. I'm going to wake you up because I love you. Yes, I love you. I'm going to wake you up, my sister. I'm going to wake you up because I care about you. And there is no other way to wake you up because you are a zombie. And I'm not insulting you because I love to insult people. No, you are a zombie because you are watching my show, you're listening to my information, and you haven't done nothing. You have done nothing. You haven't learned anything. Okay? So I'm going to hold on. Just keep being watching my show. Again, I'm not going to insult you. I'm just going to wake you up. Just stay tuned, okay? Let me call my pastor. And I'm going to put all the pieces together. Not for you, but I'm going to put the pieces together for everybody so everybody can learn. All right? Ahora, voy a llamar a un amigo de Puerto Rico que estuvo en mi chat en español y puso y publicó una parte de una grabación que yo le encontré fascinante. Lo voy a llamar, está en Puerto Rico él, lo voy a llamar. Y una vez que le llame, vamos a hacer una pequeña entrevista con él. Quiero que por favor agarres tu Biblia, porque aunque va a ser la entrevista en español, tengo que traducirla en inglés, ¿ok? Entonces yo necesito que agarres tu Biblia para que veas y demostrarte una vez más que el RB es bíblico. Si sale en la Biblia, es bíblico. El RB va a cambiar muchas cosas. Es una pequeña parte de la gran transferencia de riquezas. Por favor, te pido, con respeto, agarra la Biblia. ¿Ok? Cuando ya tenga la Biblia, voy a llamar a mi hermano en Cristo. Vamos a hablar con él. Y espero que encuentres este show muy educativo. ¿Ok? All right. All right, so I hope that this show is very educated to all of you. I really do. So let me call my pastor, and we're going to continue with the show. And my goodness, some of you got it, some of you don't get it, and trust me what I'm telling you, some of you will never get it. I'm sorry. That's the way it is. Hello, my sister.
Sir, how are you?
All right. I woke up at 2:00 in the morning, and God started talking to me again, and I start asking me the question about the prophetic word of King Clement, and I said to myself, my goodness, what is that? I mean, what is that? And then God started talking to me and said, look for this, and He started putting my pieces together in my thought. And I'm going to share the information with all of you. You guys are going to be shocked. Watch. All of you will be shocked. All of you will be shocked, people. Let me tell you this. Be ready to be shocked, okay? And, I'm going to dedicate my show again to my brother in Christ, Jan Nigo. Yanni, if you're watching my show, my man, look what I just found. Okay? I'm telling you, man, this is beautiful. You know it. I know it. God is awesome, man. God is awesome, man. There's no other way to describe my Lord. He's very busy. He's a very much busier man than me. You know, and don't get me wrong, before I became Benny, I used to like send them tests. Will barely answer back. And I understood. Okay. I understood completely. And now that I am a little bit idiot in the internet, now I got his attention, you know? But he can tell you, he used to receive my messages barely, very rarely he answered because it's not because he's cocky. He's a very busy man. He had thousands of people behind him. Okay, this guy is too big. He has done a lot of things for people to get a lot of money. So I respect him a lot. Oh, and by the way, I'm gonna address some t-shirt because I got two other people coming to me with some bullcrap about him. And I wanna make sure that everybody understands my answer. They want my answer. Yes. You two idiots want my answer. Because before you, there was another idiot who sent me the same crap. Okay? I'm not gonna mention what it is. But let me just tell you this. Let me start with this. Momento, por favor. Voy a dar un anuncio. Voy a dar una explicación. All right. First of all, the crap that you sent me about my brother in Christ, John Nigo, he ain't gonna work. If you expect me that I will come out with your bullshit, and yes, I call it bullshit, to destroy the image of my brother in Christ, Prophet John Nigo, you out of your fucking mind. If you think you can convince me because allegedly he got involved with the wrong woman, I am the last idiot to criticize another man for getting laid with the wrong woman. I have been laying down left and right with wrong women 90% of my time. Just because he's been supposedly getting involved with the wrong woman does not make him a false prophet. You're idiot. What is that got to do by coming to that, into the heaven, into the gates of heaven? Absolutely nothing. Learn that the meaning of the word salvation. Maybe you can understand. Maybe in your bullshit, you can understand why we are being saved by grace. Maybe you understand why your woman or your man has nothing to do by you putting a foot or 2 foot into heaven. It's about you and you only. It's not about you getting laid with the wrong woman. So stop your bullshit. They throw it out at me just like at the first idiot. You know, the first idiot that I kick out. And he came out saying, hey, this is the God that you praise a lot. And he sent me this bullshit. And I was like, I took a look, right? And I never seen that before. And he expecting me to stop praising him. Well, first of all, idiots, let me just tell you something. I do not praise John Nigo. I love John Nigo. He is a prophet. Just like I love every single prophet up there. God told me from the very beginning, do not touch my anointed one. Listen, look, and shut up. And that's exactly what I'm doing. So, second, I do not praise any man or any woman. I praise my Lord Jesus Christ. And third, you're full of shit. All of you, both three of us, you're full of shit. If you think that I'm going to bring up in my show some garbage, I just talked yesterday about character assassination, didn't I? I explained about character assassination and why the elite and the enemy uses character assassination to kill your image, to kill your character, to destroy your truth. And now after I basically show the whole world about my show, now you bring me this bullshit like I'm not going to be aware of. You're full of shit, guys. You guys are full of shit that I'm going to even attack black people. Seriously, wake up, man. Okay? Start the bullshit. I'm not going to be part of it. Thank you. Well, I made myself clear. You know? But, you know, this.
Well done,
yeah, I mean, I got to stop the madness. People, come on. I just got to stop the madness. You know, if it is, I said it. And look, even Tony Renfro, who complained why they put him in prison? I was the complaint, right? I told you, look what they did to him. And why? Because he brought with the people. Didn't I tell you that? For those who've been following me, I told you that, didn't I? See, he came out with the people, and the elite doesn't like that shit. Forget it. You know why? Because they are afraid of our unity. They are afraid of our unity. So what do you mean with the people? We're going to get you. They get him, and they put him in prison. Didn't I say that on my show? Yes, I did. But then again, he came out of the prison, and I thought, man, maybe this guy's going to be smarter enough. He bring the bullshit again. So there is no respect, people. I mean, what can you do? He bring the bullshit about again of the call centers and the 800 numbers. And we go back to the same shit again. I was like, man, I thought that you learned something. Yeah, I mean, I was hoping that people really change their ways, but some people don't get it, and some people will never get it. Simple as that. Estaba yo criticando porque a Tony TNT, a él lo metieron a la cárcel, y yo fui el primero en que dije, lo metieron a la cárcel, porque él organizó un grupo que se llama Nosotros la Gente, We the People. Y yo dije, eso es malo, porque la élite te va a destruir. Exactamente así fue, te mandaron a la cárcel, lo mandaron a él a la cárcel. Y yo esperé, dije, no, cuando salga de la cárcel va a cambiar su íntegro. Va a ser más calmado, va a decir la verdad, etcétera, etcétera. ¿Y qué es lo que trajo? La misma mierda. La misma basura. Así que hay gente que va a aprender y otra gente que no va a aprender. All right? Okay, so... do you have anything to say right now? Well, if you have something to say, you know, this is your platform too, you know? Okay. There's a reason why I bring you over here, remember? Go for it. So I can bring a cup of coffee because I haven't eaten. All right, go ahead. Hold on. Facebook just blocked my audio again. No. Yes. Facebook just blocked my audio again, people. I didn't know they was blocked. Like I told you, this is not the first time. Okay? Hold on. Let me fix this up. All right, go ahead. Talk. Start from the beginning.
Okay, Isaiah.
Okay, can you guys are listening? Can you understand the words that come from my sister's mouth?
Okay, I'll just talk a little bit so that they can respond.
Hold on, guys. Please tell me if you can good to go. Okay, great. Go.
Okay, great. Okay, praise God. Okay, this is Isaiah 61:7. I believe this is a scripture that God is speaking to all of us. And it says this, instead of your shame, you will have a double portion. Instead of humiliation, they will shout for joy over their portion. Therefore, they will possess a double portion in their land, and everlasting joy will be theirs. Now, that's the first scripture. The second scripture God gave me was Deuteronomy 21, verse 17. And this is what it says. Now, we're talking here about the firstborn child in every family, okay? But it says here, but God, he shall acknowledge the firstborn, the son of the unloved, by giving him a double portion of all that he has. For he is the beginning of his strength. To him belongs the right of the firstborn. Now, God began to speak to me about the truth of the firstborn to us, God's people. And, you know, in the Hebrew tradition, the firstborn child was always given a double portion of the inheritance after the parents passed away. But there was always, they're saying my sound's low.
One second. Okay. They're complaining that my sound is muffled. Now, I need you guys. Hey, I'm not mad about. I need you two guys to listen, okay? Please let me know if you can understand the words that are coming out of my mouth. Am I all good? Okay, good. Thank you. Go ahead, my sister.
I turned up my volume a little bit over here too.
No, that's
so.
Okay. No, you sound good. You sound good. Okay. I just want to make sure that the people actually sound good too. Okay.
Great.
All right.
Praise God. So Hebrew tradition, it was basically the firstborn of every family was given a double portion of an inheritance. What does that mean? Everybody got a portion. It was split up evenly, but the firstborn got twice as much. And there's a significance for that. Why did that happen in the Old Testament? Why did it happen? It actually happened in the New Testament as well. Why did it happen? Now listen, it happened because the firstborn was given the ability and given the job to take care of the family, to take care of his family, to take care of their relatives, and also to take care of the tribe or the people around them. So they were not given it because they were special or because, you know, they were given so much because they had to be blessed. No, they were given it as a responsibility. They were given it to share. They were given it to divvy out, to help people. In fact, Joseph, even though he wasn't the firstborn, he was put in a position in Egypt where he could experience the abundance of God so that he could give it out in times of famine. And you know, I realized what God was starting to say here. He was starting to tell us that we're stewards of this blessing. And yes, we have our portion, we have our blessing, but the other portion is not for us. It's to steward to the people around us, to steward to the poor, to steward to the hungry, to steward to our own families, to meet needs, to break yokes off of people. And, you know, there's a lot of work that we need to do. I wanted to say also that the firstborn today doesn't necessarily mean the firstborn in the family. And in a way, in fact, it could be the firstborn in the things of God, but in a way, it actually relates to us today because we are going to be the firstborn into the wealth transfer. We are going to be those that have understood it, have, gone the full course, we've hung on, we've prayed it through, and it makes us a type of firstborn. So this scripture is to us. So God is giving us a double portion, and we need to be stewards, faithful stewards of that. You know, when Jesus hung on the cross, when he hung there, Ben, he, one of the things he did, which I thought, you know, when I first read it, I thought, well, that's unusual. What has that got to do with anything? Jesus looked down from the cross and he saw his mother Mary. And what he said, and I'm not going to read it, but he looked at his mother and he remembered Jesus was the firstborn in his family. And Jesus took care of his mother. Jesus watched over her, provided for her, lived with her, made sure she had everything she needed and was cared for. And now he was being taken away. And it's interesting, even though he had natural brothers, Jesus had many brothers. And
I'm sorry. I had to watch my audio. Have you noticed that God speaks in a different way?
Yes.
Way different way. Look, Jesus was the firstborn of Mary. The first.
Yeah.
We know that he had a brother, right?
He had more than one, yeah.
He had more than one brother. All right.
Yep.
So, but he was the firstborn and he took care of his mother, okay?
He did.
But guess what? I'm not the firstborn. I'm the lastborn. But I am the only one taking care of my mother.
But are you the firstborn in Jesus, in the Spirit?
Yes.
There you go.
Yes.
You are the firstborn in Christ.
Yep. So, isn't it interesting? That's very interesting.
Yep. Amen.
Let me explain this in Spanish. Me estaba contando, bueno, ella estaba contando de algunas frases, de algunas partes de la Biblia. Y dijo de que Jesús básicamente era el primer hijo de María, de la Virgen María, de la Santísima Virgen María. So, yo le digo, hey, mira cómo Cristo habla, cómo Dios habla de una manera muy diferente al hombre. Él fue el primero que de María, y él cuidó de María, de su madre, hasta que murió. Él tuvo hermanos, pero él fue el primero. Yo le digo a ella, yo soy el último de mi familia, el último. Y ella me preguntó, ¿tú eres el primero en aceptar a Cristo? Y le digo, sí. Entonces, yo soy el primero en haber nacido en Cristo. El nacer de una mujer no necesariamente tiene que ser que naciste primero, sino que hay que naciste en Cristo también. ¿Ok? Para que sepa. Ok. So, let me show the people the message that I received from one of my sisters. And I want to make sure that everybody understand why I reacted like that.
Okay.
As you know, voy a hablar de una persona que me escribió a mí y yo fui muy rudo con ella. ¿Por qué fui rudo con ella? Ahorita te voy a explicar por qué. All right. As you know, guys, let me just make the warning, okay? I need to do the warning because I need to do the warning, guys, okay? All right. First of all, if you are easy to offend, please do not watch my show tonight. Don't watch it. Si tú eres muy fácil que te vaya a ofender, por favor, esta es tu advertencia, no mires mi show. Si tú eres muy fácil para ofenderte por las palabrotas que yo digo, o las cosas que yo digo, yo te ruego, por favor, que no mires mi show. All right. Second warning. Where are the words? Okay, here it is. I'm not a financial advisor. I only sharing information. You should not even watch my show. Always talk to a professional. Yo no soy un consejero financiero, para nada. Yo solamente soy un idiota, ¿ok? Tú no deberías ni ver mi show. Si tú necesitas un consejo financiero, yo te voy a recomendar que tú hables con un consejero profesional financiero. Te lo estoy diciendo. Esta es tu advertencia, ¿ok? All right. And what is the last warning? My last warning is that Divine Intel is purely for entertainment purposes only. Any similar real events are purely coincidental. And in Spanish. Esta es tu última advertencia. Intel Divino es un show puramente para entretenerte. Para que la pases bien. Cualquier otra cosa que pase que sea similar o de los eventos reales es puramente coincidencia. Y si tú tienes la lógica bien puesta, tú sabrás por qué yo tengo que cubrir mi nalga, mi espalda y por qué lo estoy haciendo. ¿Verdad? Espero que sí. Porque tengo idiotas que me dicen, hey, entonces quiere decir que tu información es, no es pura, no es Intel, te contradices. Así me han llegado idiotas. No entienden. Todo lo quieren en la boca, todo lo quieren bien explicado. No entienden. Son retrasados mentales, son zombies. I got people coming to me right now and tell me, oh, so your show is entertainment purposes only. Then you're full of shit. they just told me right now. Then you're full of shit. Your Intel is full of shit. And I answer, yes, it is full of shit. Why are you still watching? Why are you still watching, you retard? If you believe that my show is pure entertainment, which it is, if you cannot even come out with your brain and just take your head out of your ass, why are you still watching? Why? Why do you need me to spoon feed you all the time? I mean, it's so hard for you to use your brain, your zombie, because that's what you are. You are a zombie. All right? Thank you. All right, so some people will get it and some people will not get it. Never will get it. All right, so let me tell you what I'm going to do, okay? I'm going to read the message of this sister. Are you there? Are you watching my show, my sister? Let me read exactly the message that you sent me and why I was so rude with you, okay? Because that's the way I am. I use therapy. I use a therapy that is implosive. I use this therapy and this language because I care about you. I care so much about you, I don't want nothing to happen to you. I really don't want nothing happen bad to you. That's what I respond that way. I'm just going to mention your first name. I'm not going to mention your whole name. Becky, are you there? Because you are speaking English, and I don't know if you are Latino or whatever. I'm just gonna answer your message, and I'm gonna tell you why I was so rude with you. Okay, all right, here we go. She comes to me and she goes, Benny, Facebook kicks me out every time I access your page. Well, welcome to reality. Facebook doesn't want you to listen to my show. Okay, I still amazed that they have not kicked me out. All right, I'm still amazed. I should be kicked out a long time ago. Are you still there, sister?
I'm here, and I'm amazed too. I was thinking that this afternoon.
All right, so let me continue reading the message. She said, Benny, Facebook kicks me out every time I access your page, but it works for everyone else. Wanted to share that with you. And she mentioned another name. That's a male name. I'm not going to mention the name. Okay, I'm not going to mention the name. Then she goes down here, and then she goes, Benny, I'll be waiting at Vimeo to hear the discussion because Facebook doesn't seem to like your name at all. Hello. Unless you understand why. All right. How do I get to the green light chat? If I can access your page, any suggestion? Email? ? Number one, my sister or even my brother, please understand simple instructions. I personally, Benny, cannot send you nothing. But I will take care of you. That's all I can tell you. Okay? But why I was so rude with you? Why did I use profanity? Let me tell you why. Let me read the whole message. I said underneath, do you watch my show? That was a question mark. Do you pay attention? That was another question mark. Or do you even give a fuck if my information, because you probably don't give a fuck about my information. You don't care about my information. And I said, I can see you don't. And most of you are saying, man, what did she do wrong, right? Okay, I'll tell you right now. Hold on. So she goes, I listen to your show all the time. Sorry to bother you. You're not bothering me. You're never bothering me. But I will tell you one more time why I was so pissed. Because you are a zombie. Do you just listen to what I said? I hope that you understand this. You are a zombie. I've been screaming. I've been warning. Take your stupid pictures off your Facebook page, because one day know that you got a lot of money, they're going to go after you. What part of that you don't understand? What? My God, I mean, what? People are brainless. You're watching on the news how Facebook is trying to find out how much money you got from your accounts. This is no lie, people. They want to know how much money you got. They have been put up in Congress because they violated privacy and antitrust rules and laws. And on top of that, they confessed that they got hacked. They never got hacked, people. They never got hacked. They're after you, and they will come and they will destroy you. My last show was about character assassination. But then again, I'm not your daddy. You do what the fuck you want to do. But don't come crying on me when they get you. Don't come crying with me. That's what I got pissed off. Some people get it. Some people don't get it. My sister, it was her husband in the picture. Beautiful people, but in the wrong place. You are in the next of the corruption. You are in the next of the most deceiving social media in the world. 50 million accounts were hacked. Do you understand that? 50 million. That's only what they report. It's believed that it actually reached 1.5 billion. And I'm not making this up. So that's why I was so rude with you. Because you're brainless. You haven't done shit. You want me to put you in a chat room. Guess what's going to happen to you? They're going to remind you why. Because you haven't done anything. And don't tell me I don't know how to do it. There's tutorials on YouTube. You can even ask other people, hey, look, man, can you get rid of all these pictures? Because I'm going to be filter rich. I don't want these motherfuckers come out over me. Yeah, do it. What is your problem? But then again, I'm not your daddy, right? All right. And I even told her, I will mention your message in my show. And I will mention why I insulted you. How about that? I even said, maybe after you listen to my show, you finally wake up and pay attention. And I will also publicly apologize to you. So this is my public apologize. I'm sorry that I insulted you. But there is no other way that I can find out to wake you up. There is no other way. And I don't know if you are Christian or Catholic or whatever, but let me just wake you up again. We are in the last days. There is no more space for being political correct. No space, people. We are living the last days. That is why I do the things that I do. That is why I get so frustrated and I so get angry. People don't have a fucking idea what is after them. Watch. You got no fucking idea what's going to happen to you. Nothing. Are you there, sister?
I am right here, Ben, right beside you.
Sometimes God has to shake you.
Absolutely. I get it. Totally.
And trust me, you don't want to be shaken by God. Because when you get shaken by God, you're going to cry, you're going to suffer. It's going to be really great surrendering. Grave surrendering.
Amen.
But you rather get insulted, not humiliated, because I haven't shown your face. I will never insult your character. I will never reveal your picture because I love you. I know and I respect people's privacy. But if you don't want to take my information serious, that's exactly what's going to happen to you. I don't want nothing to happen to you and to your husband and to your beautiful children. You got all the pictures of your family. All your family is beautiful. Keep it that way. Get it out of the fucking media and be helpful. Be blessed. Why do you need people's attention? You don't need that. Protect your identity. Did I contradict myself? And now let me mention something else. Un momento, amigos, porque acabo de insultar a una mujer que me manda un pedido que yo le ayude a que le meta un chat. Y ella tiene la fotografía con el esposo. Son lindas personas. Y ella espera que yo le ayude. Y le dije yo, le insulté porque no pone atención. ¿Por qué? Porque muchos de ustedes lo único que esperan es saber cuándo van a ir a cambiar. De allí, protegerse les vale madre. Les vale madre. A todos ustedes les vale madre la protección. Y cuando les va a pasar, entonces van a regresar conmigo y te van a decir, mira, me robaron la identidad. Me robaron esto. Porque lo primero que se te va a hacer es la identidad, people. La primera. Why am I so concerned? Because the first thing that you're going to lose is your identity. I got policemen listening to my show. You want me to bring one? I got police people from LAPD, Los Angeles Police Department. I got two people from the New York Police Department. And they applauded me. And they say, Benny, you are the only one who's waking up people. Because the first thing that will go after this happen, it will be your identity. They're going to steal your identity. Mark my words. You're going to lose everything you got. Why? Because the enemy is going to kill the baby before the RV, during the RV, and after the RV. That's why I need to repeat myself all the time because people don't fucking get it. You're a zombie. You see why God even told me that I'm surrendered by zombies? You are a zombie. You don't think with your brain. You don't think with your brain. Even God told me you are surrendered by zombies. I was like, what? I had to bring somebody to tell me. And I didn't get it until my elder told me. A zombie is a dead man with no consciousness that can walk and do anything like a living person. That's you. That is you. A zombie. Are you there?
I'm right here.
Sorry for that.
That's okay.
So I make my public apology to her, and because I love you. That's why. I love you, and I don't want nobody to touch you. I don't want nobody to steal your identity. I don't want nothing to happen to you. Okay? So that's why I insulted you. I use profanity. I shake you up. Because I'm your brother. Because if I was not your brother, I would not even give a fuck. I would not even care about you. But I care about you. All right. Sister.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to talk about breaking the system.
Ooh, I like it.
Vamos a hablar del rompimiento del sistema. So, por favor, ponga mucha atención, lo voy a explicar en inglés y ahorita te lo explico en español. No tengas, por favor, ten un poquito de paciencia. Yo sé que hablo mucho inglés, pero aprende también a respetar a de que la gran mayoría son anglosajones, no hablan español. Así que me va a tomar un poquito más de tiempo en explicarlos en inglés y voy a un poquito de tiempo explicarlo en español, porque el español es florido, pero es completo. Y te lo puedo decir en pocas palabras. Y tú ya lo entiendes y lo agarras así. ¿Ok? Así son los dos lenguajes. What I just said in Spanish. I had to speak more in English, not because English is better. is because it takes more time for me to explain. Okay? Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. in Spanish, our language is more complete. It takes less words to explain, and people will just get it like that. Got it?
That's good.
Okay? So that's why I take more time explaining it in English, because people need to understand why these things are happening. All right? All right. Now, let me explain what happened. I woke up in the morning. Hey, Johnny, if you're watching, look what happened to me today, okay? I woke up in the morning. Hold on, let me see. Hold on 1 second, guys. I had to do it right now, you know? Okay. There you go. I got the information now. Now let me explain to you. When I woke up, the first thing when I wake up between 1 o'clock in the morning to 3 o'clock in the morning. That's when God starts speaking to me. He loves to wake me up, and then I need to go back to sleep and wake up tired. Hey, what can I tell you?
Okay, that was funny.
Yeah, so he started, you know, putting thoughts in my mind, just like yesterday, you know? And guess what God said? He said he put me into thinking about the prophecy of King Clement. Johnny, mm-hmm. are you listening? He told me to think about the prophecy of King Clement, and I was like, yes, I'm in there. And then I thought, the earth will shake and shake again. That's what I thought. And I was like, the earth will shake and shake again. I was like, the earth will shake and shake again. And I was just thinking the same thing. I was like, wait a minute. I know what God is trying to tell me. You see, God does not speak like you speak. And God does not think the way you think. I think I made that very clear, right?
Amen.
Right? So let me just go back over here. Let me show you my computer. Sorry for that. Let me show you my computer. This is what I came out with. Watch. In 2004, Indonesia had a tsunami and the earthquake. That was in 2004. When was the prophecy of the dinar? February 2004. That the earth will shake. And when he says shake again, means Indonesia. Indonesia shake again 2 days ago, had an earthquake and had another tsunami. Are you listening, my brother in Christ, Dan Nigo? So they have again another tsunami. Indonesia had another tsunami, another earthquake. The earth will shake and shake again. Now let me go back to the prophecy. And God is not contradicted. God says in his prophetic word, I'm talking about Iran and Iraq and the southern regions. And Southern Asia. Okay, where Indonesia is located? Southern Asia. Southern Asia. So when he mentioned, because you know it's like a riddle, that's the way God speaks, because he doesn't want the devil to destroy it. It's a mystery. We need to basically research and try to decode the prophetic word, because it's not easy. It's just like the Bible. It's just like the Bible. It's not easy.
Hidden truth, Benny.
It is a hidden truth. So now we got the truth. We know that 2004, that day, that year that the prophetic word was done, and now we got the two separate earthquakes with two separate tsunamis. And now let me tell you what. Now we know that Indonesia is in the Saudi region. Now please pay attention, because this is information that I can share with you. This is intel. Okay? And the intel goes like this. But before I go, let me explain to you in Spanish.
Oh boy. Okay. I forgot to remind you. Sorry.
Yes, sorry for that. Déjeme hablarle ahora en español. En el año 2004 fue que se dio la profecía del dinar. Se dio en febrero de 2004. Con mucha atención. En el 2004 de diciembre. Oh, another thing. Hold on. The earthquake of Indonesia. The first time. Guess what it was. Guess when it was. Sister?
It was on...
Yes, you don't know?
I don't know.
It was in December.
Oh, yeah.
It was, apparently, I found out that it was December the 26th. It says right here, okay. December the 19th, but I don't think so. It was December the 26th. I remember that day. It was right wow. after Christmas. Okay.
Oh boy.
December
okay.
December the 26th, 2014. Yeah, but it says December 2014. December. I don't think so. It was 2004. Let me go back. Let me see.
Yeah, 2004. You're right.
Yeah,
you're
2004,
correct.
2004. Yeah. Right. Okay.
10 months after the prophecy.
Exactly. So it was 2004, the first time the Earth shake. Yeah,
that's right.
And now we have it right now. On October, and by the way, remember what I told you about October in the prophecy of that prophet that said that it probably gonna hit 27,000. I got the latest analyst chart from my biggest and most experienced trader, and I'm gonna.
Oh no!
It. Yes, wait. I'm
oh
gonna
no!
You. I'm gonna okay. shock you. Watch. I'm gonna shock you. So let me explain now in Spanish because it's. Worth it. Ok, en febrero del 2004 fue la profecía del dinar y cayó el primer terremoto con el tsunami en diciembre 26 del 2004. Diciembre 26 del 2004. La tierra se sacudirá y se sacudirá otra vez. Ya tenemos dos terremotos en Indonesia, dos tsunamis en Indonesia. Después dice la palabra profética. Estoy hablando de las regiones de Irán e Irak y de las regiones del sur y de Asia del sur. ¿Dónde queda Indonesia? Indonesia o Indonesia queda en el sur de Asia. ¿Ok? Oh my goodness, hold on. Hold on.
Woman of God, how you doing? Hello? 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 Oh, hold on. Hello?
Hello?
Okay, hold on. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. God bless you. I'm
okay,
here.
Kali just called me and she did not answer. It's okay. Let's continue this. Kali, if you're okay. listening to me, please call back. All right, so sorry for that. So anyway... like I was saying in Spanish. Entonces, eso fue el terremoto que pasó hace dos días o tres días. Entonces, la palabra profética te lo dice porque Indonesia está en el sur de Asia. Así que ahí está toda la palabra profética, ¿ok? Y ahora te voy a decir qué va a pasar porque viene otra cosa más tremenda. Porque la palabra profética lo está diciendo, ¿ok? All right. Déjame explicarlo primero en inglés. All right, so we covered when was the earthquake from Indonesia, right?
Mm-hmm. December 26th.
The 26th. And then we covered when was the last time, the same thing. It was an earthquake and we got a tsunami, right?
Correct.
Okay. What is next? Let's go back to the prophetic word.
Okay.
All right, so talking the regions, the earth will shake and shake again. and the southern regions. And now, let's talk about the break in the system. As you know, we've been trying to figure out what is the break in the system. Yes, Johnny got it right. It's going to be when every single country goes solo, right? It means solo. That when they don't want to trade against the dollar, and because it's basically a very strong dollar, is not good for them. It's not good for them, okay? Let me just put it that way. Because a lot of things will be even expensive for them. So they're going to have to break. All right? So I told you that if we reach 27,000 on the Dow Jones, Europe will collapse. Europe will collapse, people. No other way. I just told you why. Because a strong dollar is not good for their business. It's not good. It's not good for the United States. It is not good for Europe. Okay? So, when it collapses, will you consider that a break in the system?
Oh, yeah.
That's a break in the system, right?
It is. Totally.
Okay? So, it's going to break. And then, the dinar. That's what he said, the prophecy. After the break in the system, there will be a break in the system. That dinar, that's the way he said it. That's the way our Lord said it. That dinar. We're going to see something in the dinar. No, we're not going to see a revaluation, people. We're going to see something. Do you understand that? Or should I tell you exactly what I'm talking about?
I think you better explain it.
Let me explain it before I explain it in Spanish. The prophet King Clement said this, nothing, 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 then suddenly something. Okay? Is something $3?
Nope.
Is something $5?
Nope.
Is something 1-to-1?
Not really.
Not really. Why? Because the economy doesn't work like that. Unless we got a break in the system. Do you guys understand that? And I'm going to make sure that you guys use your brain. Because I'm going to prove you one more time why TNT Tony, Ray Ren, Bruce, Phil Tilton, Uta, and every single guru out there have been lying to you for more than 10 years. The economy does not work that way and will never work that way until we got a break in the system. If we got a break in the system, I believe everything. I believe those retards telling you, hey, it's going to be $15, the dinar, $28, whatever. I really don't care. You want to follow your greed? Go for it. Knock yourself out. But the economy will never work like that. Okay? So, what is something? Something is like this. Currencies do not revalue hugely like 1-to-1 or 1-to-20. Currency usually shows a signal of being alive. Are you understanding this? Are you following me? Currencies, actually, when they are alive, you can see switch down, up, down, up. It's still devalued, but it goes down, up. It's living. It's been floating. That is what the word is called, floating. Okay? So, what is something? Something means positive value. You need to understand the very easy terminology of math. Something has a value, is positive. It has a value, is positive. It has no value, is program. It is the value. Got it? Am I being clear?
Yeah. Go.
All right,
it's good.
So, is 1 cent a positive value? Yes, it is.
Yes.
1 cent.
That's a good one.
1 cent. Is 2 cents a positive value? Of course.
Yes.
Anything that goes above 1 cent, it has a value. That's something. That's something. So when it goes to something, what are you going to do? Are you going to sit back and wait for the fucking 800 number, not knowing who you're going to be talking to? What are you going to do? That information, I just have it. You don't. For those people in YouTube, you don't have the information. I have it. My people is prepared for the best and the worst.
Amen.
Okay? For the best and the worst. So that's what it is. What are you going to do? Are you going to sit back and wait for Uta or Joseph or TNT Tony or all those retards telling you, oh, here's your 800 number. Don't listen to that fucker. Go and talk to, go, call. And everybody trying to call this fucking 800 number, not being able to get a line, chaos and panic will prevail. Did I contradict myself?
No.
I don't think so. I think I clean it. I think I assassinating the liars. I think I'm educating you. You tell me about one guru, bring up some logic in his bullshit or her bullshit. Tell me the name, and I promise you, I give you my word, I will go public and apologize to that guru. Give me the word. Give me the logic of their supposedly intel. Give me the logic, people. I got a guy who sent me another stupid bullshit. What do you think about this, Benny? What I think? I think you're full of shit. I did tell him that. Because you guys are more worried about why we don't have an RB, and you're filling your brains, if you think you have one, of fairy tales. Dinarlan is the land that is filled with fairy tales, aliens, a lot of that bullshit out there without no logic, people, no logic. I have talked about aliens. Did you know that? For those who are not in my private call, I have talked about aliens. And even after I explain it, they go, wow, man, why did they do this? They're full of shit, man. Why? Because you don't want to take your head out of your ass and pay attention. If people understood the logic, they respect it. That's why. There is a big logic, and it's called wisdom. That's something that you don't have. And to tell you the truth, I really, really wish I could have it that much. They have wisdom because they're way, way ahead of us. They know what they're going to do, and they do exactly as they say. They don't care about contacting a moron over there. Oh, I know what they look like. They look like lizards. Oh, look how they walk. And I saw them pull up a ray. And they go into a lot of bullshit up there because there's a lot of people saying, I'm an alien contact. None of them are. That's the big deception, people. That is the big deception. None of them have seen them. Because even if they have a first encounter, their life will be shocked and last forever. They will not even talk right. Because they are too high and their energy is too high level. It can actually kill you if you're not careful. But you don't understand anything of that, do you? And I'm not going to waste my time talking about aliens here. Was I right? Was that clear?
That was clear, and don't forget the Spanish.
Oh, thank you. Ok, vamos a hablar. Ok, ahora vamos a hablar del rompimiento del sistema. El rompimiento del sistema va a suceder cuando alcancemos 27,000, ¿ok? En el Dow Jones. ¿Por qué? Porque Europa va a colapsar. Va a colapsar porque a Europa no le conviene tener un dólar alto, fuerte. No le conviene, no puede hacer negocios. Entonces, cuando llega a 27,000 el Dow Jones, va a colapsar Europa. ¿Tú considerarías eso un rompimiento del sistema? Claro que sí. Eso va a ser el rompimiento del sistema. ¿Por qué? Porque no van a poder comerciar en contra del dólar. Van a tener que irse solo. Van a tener que hacerlo aparte. Van a tener que comerciar en contra de otra moneda. Puede ser el yuan, puede ser la puede ser lo cual sea. No me importa. Pero no van a comerciar contra el dólar. Cuando pase eso, va a ser el rompimiento del sistema. El sistema está diseñado para que todas las monedas se comercien en pares. ¿Cuál es el otro contraparte del par? El dólar americano. Cuando sepan que el dólar americano es demasiado alto para comerciar, se van a mover a otra moneda. Puede ser el yuan de China o puede ser cualquier otra moneda. Pero se van a romper del sistema. Espero que lo hayas entendido ahorita. Ahora voy a hablar de la charta que me mandó mi comerciante peruano. Es el que tiene más experiencia. Voy a tratar de leerla para que veas qué tan cerca estamos para el rompimiento del sistema. Espero que hayan entendido esta breve pero muy poderosa explicación en español. Si no la entienden, por favor, escríbenla ya y voy a tratar de repetírtelo otra vez. No lo creo porque el español es florido y es más completo que el inglés. Por eso yo me tardo más en inglés. Ok. So let me see if people, Latino people, just got it the first time. I bet they did. They're laughing, so they got it. All right, so let's talk about the chart, shall we? Take a look at my beautiful computer. Ah! Here we go.
Are you okay?
I'm not. I'm very excited.
Okay.
All right.
Me too.
Look at that line. This is going to the roof. And now, boom. The green line means buying.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, I'm sorry. That's the green line. Yeah, there's buying because they're selling. The green line is selling. Take a look at this. Let me just put a little bit bigger. Okay. It says high volume selling. So right now they're selling. People are buying. Take a look at this little arrow. So as you can see, the low volume right here. Take a look. We're going up. And now it's falling and then went up again. And we are getting close to 26,672.
Wow.
We are close, but guess what? Look at the tendency. This is the tendency right here. It's coming down again. That's the tendency. Okay? Mm. So maybe we have to wait a little bit more time to hit 27,000. But according to what I read right here, I even asked him, look, man, you're telling me we're not going to hit 27,000? He hasn't answered yet. Hold on. Let me just back to the email because I don't want you guys to know who it is. Nino, if you are watching my show, please let me know. Are we going to hit 27,000 or not? Come on, man.
Well, it went up 672. So if it goes up another.
I'll tell you what. Let me show you. Let me show you how we are. Take a look at my computer, please. Okay, it's in the news. Take a look at the news. When was the agreement signed? It was signed today. Was the announcement, right?
Right.
The announcement was today. Take a look at the news.
That's with Canada?
Yes, with Canada. And yay! Mexico. They're all the same. So okay. Dow rises nearly 200 points after the U.S., Canada strike a deal to replace NAFTA.
Oh.
Okay, so it's 200 points up, people. 200 points up. Now, let me tell you something about Mexico and Canada. Shall we?
Okay.
Let me explain in Spanish now. Después de que se hizo el anuncio el nuevo acuerdo de comercio entre Canadá y Estados Unidos, el Dow se fue arriba 200 puntos. Todavía, según la charta que me mandó mi comerciante peruano, la tendencia va para arriba. Ahorita estamos en una escala que se llama donde se están vendiendo. Aquí está la charta que lo dice todo. Todo se está vendiendo, pero aquí sale que el volumen es bajo. Lo que concuerda que podríamos llegar a 26,672. ¿A cuánto está el Dow Jones? El Dow Jones ahorita está, déjeme enseñarles, let me see what's the Dow Jones right now. Dow Jones is 26,651. All right, 26,651. And it's up about 192, it's almost 200, just like they said. Ha subido 26,651. Mira cómo se ve la charta aquí, parece que va para arriba, pero aquí arriba se ve una resistencia. Lo cual, lo que dice él es que la tendencia va a caer para abajo. O sea que vamos a tener que esperar un poquitito para que llegue a 27,000. La charta nunca te va a engañar. La charta no te va a engañar. Déjame leer lo que él me dijo en inglés. No puedo enseñarte el nombre de él. All right, so let me go back over here. Let me just tell you what he said. He said, we are on the break point or pullback. Looking for next support like before. Very clear. If we are on a breaking point of pullback, means the tendency is going down now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So we are not there yet. But trust me what I'm telling you. If we reach 27,000, we will see chaos and panic. Yes, we will. Even the prophet King Clement said, don't pay attention, but observe the stock exchange.
Huh? That's right, he did.
He said that. Don't pay attention, but observe the stock exchange.
Just watch it, but don't.
Don't pay attention, because if you pay attention, you're going to fall for chaos and panic. All right? And they're calling me right now, and hold on. It's a pastor. Why he called? Oh. Estoy en el show, señor. Estoy en el show. All right, so I'm sorry, but I cannot answer questions because I'm in my show. So... Let me explain this in Spanish. Dios, I mean, no Dios, sino que, bueno, la palabra de Dios dijo con el profeta de que tendríamos que no pongamos atención al stock exchange, pero observemos. Así dijo él. Entonces, cuando lleguemos a 27,000 va a haber caos y pánico en la bolsa de valores, porque Europa se va a colapsar. Se va a colapsar, no va a poder comerciar con una moneda tan alta. No digamos nuestra economía. Ahora te voy a explicar algo acerca de Canadá y México. Solamente espera un poquito. All right, so let me explain to you about Mexico and Canada. I told you on my show, your people from Canada, your leader, your prime minister is a puppet from the cabal. Did I tell you that?
You did.
Okay. So why did he sign the agreement? Because he was forced. He was forced to do it. And look at that, Donald Trump. What did he say about him? I like him. He cares about his people. He loves his people. And everybody thought that he was talking about the Canadian people. No, he wasn't. He was talking about the people from the cabal. He loves his cabal. He loves his club. You don't understand this because he talks politically. He's telling you the truth. He loves his people from the cabal, not the Canadian people. Mm-hmm. He doesn't care about you. Okay? And that's the reason how these things happen. By agreement. By agreement. The old elite is losing the battle. And after this, guess what's going to happen? Did I mention on my last show that your minister will be removed?
Yes.
I think I did, didn't I?
Say I think so.
Say goodbye to that retard. Say goodbye to that criminal. Say goodbye to your prime minister. It's going to be removed. And it's going to be removed before his administration ends. Mark my words.
Praise the Lord.
Mark my words. Mark my words. He's leaving. He's going to be removed. Watch what's going to happen to him. Watch is going to be priceless. It's going to be priceless, people. Okay? Simple as that. Is not when is his term is going to be finished?
We're actually going into elections, but they're district elections. His term is finished in, I think, another year.
In another year. Well, he's leaving before that year is over.
Oh, I can't wait.
Okay. He's leaving before the year is over. Mark my words.
We're working on it.
Okay. Trust me. Yeah. It's going to happen. Watch. Okay, now let me explain in Spanish. This is so difficult.
Oh, my goodness. Take a break. Take a sip of water.
Okay. El presidente de Canadá es un títere del clan, del Illuminati. Es un títere. Y él no quería firmar este tratado. Entonces, ahora que lo firmó, lo van a sacar del poder. Él va a salir antes que termine su reinado, pues va a su administración, ¿ok? Cuando Donald Trump se refirió de él, le dijo, oh, no, yo, a mí me gusta, él quiere mucho, él ama mucho a su gente. Y toda la gente pensó que estaba hablando de que la gente de Canadá, no, él no dijo eso. Él estaba refiriéndose a la gente del club de él, Illuminati. Por eso que él no quería firmar el tratado. Ahora te voy a decir de México. Pero espérate que lo voy a explicar en inglés. Now let's talk about Mexico, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
Pay attention, please, because this is your intel. Now, remember, I'm not your financial advisor. And this show is for entertainment purposes only. Any current event or actual event is purely confidential. Are we all agree with it? I hope so. Who was the only guru out there who told you that the potential of the Bolivar was going to go up? Was it Bruce? Was it TNT Tony? Who? I don't think I have to tell you, right? Now, who told you about the Colombian peso?
I know who.
Okay. And who told you about the Mexican peso? I told you, didn't I? I said, look, the peso and the Mexican peso is going to revalue. And not many Mexican people do believe me. They don't believe me because they are into a big bubble. You know what is that big bubble? That big bubble is called Mexico, the land of ignorance. Yes, and I'm not insulting Mexico. I love Mexico. I love Mexican people with all my heart. But it's ignorance. They have kept the people. They have kept the Mexican people in ignorance, that they don't have nothing. All they have is poor, is poverty. They don't have nothing. They're useless. They have to come over here illegally. They're surviving. They don't have nothing because of the last elites have been actually doing a great job, you know, keeping the people in ignorance. But guess what? Mexico is 40 or even 50 times more rich than Japan. I'm not making this up. Mexico is how can I explain it? Remember the prophecy of King Clement where he said, and there will be prosperity in the places you less expected?
Correct.
Guess what he was talking about? He was talking about a lot of countries like Mexico. Watch. Mm-hmm. Mexico will revalue. That's all I gotta tell you. You do whatever you want because I'm not your daddy. Okay? I'm not your daddy. Okay, so why is it that industrial average went up 200 points? Because there are two big daddies in the north side of America. Canada, USA, and Mexico. Bingo. But then again, some people will look and learn, and some people will just say, nah, you're full of shit, man. That's the way it is. That's normalcy bias, people. Normalcy bias, yes. Normalcy bias. There are people out there that are not ready to the shift. They're not ready. Okay? And let me explain now in Spanish. Okay. ¿Por qué el Dow Jones subió 200 pesos, 200 puntos, después de que se firmó el tratado con Canadá? Porque el tratado no solamente es con Canadá, también es con México. Porque México es un potencial grandísimo. México tiene más riquezas que Japón. México tiene hasta 50 veces el dinero que podría tener Japón en toda su historia. México es básicamente una gran burbuja que se llama México. ¿Por qué? Porque la burbuja de México está llena de ignorancia. Todos los gobiernos anteriores han mantenido a los mexicanos en un plan de ignorancia. Todos son ignorantes. Todos no tienen ni la idea qué tan bello y qué tan grande y qué tan tremendo es la economía mexicana. Porque te han mantenido ignorante del gran potencial que tienes tú, tu país y tu moneda. Tu moneda va a revaluar. King Clement dijo... Habrá prosperidad hasta en los lugares menos esperados. México es uno de ellos. México va a ser grande, va a ser tan poderoso, va a ser una economía como nunca en tu vida lo has soñado. Porque tú naciste para ser grande, México lindo y bello. Tú naciste para ser el camino de toda Latinoamérica. Tú, México, tú vas a ser grande y bello. Yo te lo apuesto y no me importa que muchos mexicanos me hayan insultado. Te estoy diciendo que tú serás realeza entre todos los países de Latinoamérica. Tú, México, tú. Así que tu moneda va a subir de precio y cuando tengas ese precio positivo en contra del dólar, todo lo que era caro se volverá completamente barato. Y todo lo que era pobreza se volverá riqueza. Encontrarás trabajo por todos lados. Encontrarás oportunidades para educarte, para trabajar, para tener tu propia casa, etcétera, etcétera. Muchos mexicanos regresarán a México y de mí te vas a acordar. Porque mucha gente no sabe el potencial que tiene México. Porque te han puesto en el pecado de la mediocridad. Han habido no uno, sino que varios profetas dentro de México que cuando dan la profecía, ¿qué crees que la gente hace? Se ríe. Se ríe porque no cree. Solo mira el presidente que Dios te puso. Un presidente que es humilde. Que no quiere manejar, que no quiere que ni que lo llamen, ni que lo lleven como lo que es, como un presidente de un país grande. Él quiere ser igual que tú y él siempre te recuerda, yo no quiero ser igual como los otros presidentes por la gran pobreza que hay en México. Cuando él empieza a ser presidente, él va a quitar la pobreza de México. Y déjame recordarte algo que yo dije en mi show. Prepárate para el gran jubileo de México. El gran jubileo de México viene. Yo lo profeticé y vas a ver que hay otros que lo han profetizado. Tu jubileo viene. Millones de mexicanos van a recibir mucho dinero porque van a sacar todos los tesoros que se ha escondido de todos los mexicanos. De mí te vas a acordar. There will be a Mexican Jubilee. I said in Spanish, and I'm going to tell you straight out. There will be a Jubilee, a Mexican Jubilee. All the treasures, all the gold, all the silver that Mexico have is going to share it with every single Mexican. And watch how poverty is erased out of the world. And you'll see why Mexico is going to become an example in the world. Watch, mark my words. Mexico will have their own Jubilee. I said it 3 years ago. So congratulations. Watch as your economy launch all the way to heaven.
Praise God.
Hey, so, that was something. Yep. That was something.
Hallelujah.
It comes back, you know, and then I was really laughed at. I was attacked, I was laughed at because people thought that I was, you know, full of it.
Mm-hmm.
When I told you, no, you guys are going to be filthy rich.
Praise God.
And they were like, how do you know, man? You're full of it. We're great. In poverty. There is no signal. Of course not, because that's normalcy bias. That's normalcy bias right there.
Yeah.
You know, I want to congratulate also the Dinar Real community for your 13,000 of members. I want to congratulate you. I mean, you have done a tremendous job. And keep going, man. You're doing a great job. I sending you all the trolls to you because I know you love them.
You're so generous.
What do you want me to do? You know, I'm generous with everybody, guys. Are you kidding me? Look, when they come to me, hey, man, Bruce told me this. Go back to Bruce.
Amen.
Go back to Bruce. He's going to tell you. And then another guy came out to me, man, the man who knows, he said that they will be here and here. I said, okay, go back to him. Why? Why you don't want to tell me? Because he is the one who knows.
There you
He's
go.
The one who knows, right? So go back to him. Tell him to explain to you why and where is the proof. Just ask him that. Tell him, hey, Benny wants you to prove it.
Good luck on that.
Look, do you know how to get in contact with him? Yeah, I know. Okay, go back to him. Tell him, you know what, Benny? You know, Benny Wilson? I don't know if you heard him. Maybe you didn't. Can you please tell me and prove me that what you just said is truth? Go ahead. Ask him. Because a lot of people come to me with that. Hey, man, do you have any proof? And I'm very clear about it. Like, for example, yesterday, you know, a prophet came out to me and said, can you please tell me the scripture where he said the black people are royal people? I never said it was in the Bible.
That's right.
I never said it was in the Bible. Okay, but hey, if I find it, which I really doubt it because God doesn't want me to read the Bible, you know, I will let you know.
Well, one of the three wise men was black.
Exactly.
There you go.
Who knows? Maybe Jesus was black. I really don't care about his skin color. I really don't care about his skin color, guys.
Whatever color his skin is, he's pretty bright now.
Oh, my God. He's full of light. He's light.
Yeah.
He's full of light. Oh, he's full of it. I'm telling you. He is the sun, even brighter than the sun.
Amen. Amen.
All right. So, Spanish, vamos a darte más intel, vamos a tocar un video, y te voy a decir de qué se trata, y después de eso vamos a regresar, vamos a llamarle a un hermano en Puerto Rico, ¿ok? So, what I'm going to do right now, I'm just going to play one video, and I'm going to let you know what it's about, and after I play that video, I'm going to call my brother in Christ in Puerto Rico, ¿ok? And I'm going to make a little bit introduction of who he is and the information that he shared in the chat room. Okay. And I'm going to let you guys know what's going to happen next. Watch. Because we are putting all the pieces together. Right. We are putting all the pieces together. And then you will know why the prophet in Puerto Rico was 100% right. Okay. All right. So let's watch the video. And I'll call you back, my sister.
No problem. Enjoy.
All right. Enjoy. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Enjoy the wonderful video.
All right, welcome back to Currency 365. It is October 1st, 2018, new month. Hope you guys are doing well. Like the video, subscribe, and share, and get ready for an awesome month. Got some Zimbabwe news on Twitter from My Zimbabwe News, and it says, as I correctly predicted yesterday. So we're just going to hold it right there because let's just see what he was talking about from yesterday. So let's go here, and then we'll come back. So this is what he was talking about from yesterday. It says monetary policy. So tomorrow, which is today, when the governor, John, delivers his monetary policy, expect to hear something along the lines of official U.S. Dollar accounts, be it new FCAs or turning every account into a pure FCA, as was the case before. Certainly the bond note days are numbered. Okay, so now let's go back and let's see what he has for us today. Okay, says, as I correctly predicted yesterday, the RBZ has reintroduced official U.S. dollar bond bank accounts, in the form of foreign currency accounts. Let me repeat that. As I correctly predicted yesterday, the RBZ has reintroduced official U.S. dollar bank accounts in the form of foreign currency accounts, the FCAs, okay? The next step is to secure enough funding, then totally do away with the bond notes, okay? So it says finance minister's fiscal policy. We'll touch on this later.
All right, so let me pause it right there and let me explain to you what's going on. Number one, please pay attention because I'm going to educate you one more time and I'm going to tell you that I never contradict myself. All right, here we go. Didn't I tell you the philosophy of the elites? Don't do what I do. Don't listen what I do. Follow what I do. Don't listen what I say. Do what I do. It's the same thing. So don't listen to the elite. Whatever they tell you is totally the opposite. Did I contradict myself? I don't think so. I told you, they came out first and said, we need to get rid of the bond notes. And then all of a sudden, the president of Zimbabwe came out and says, no, we're going to hold on to the bond notes. He lied. The president, the guy who's supposed to be the non-corrupted, he told the whole world, no, we're going to hold on to the bond notes. And now we got news that they're actually opening the United States dollar accounts on foreign currency accounts. And they tell you right there, the next step is to secure enough funding, then totally do away with the bond notes. They're going to get rid of the bond notes, people. I told you, didn't I? I told you bond notes are gone. There is no value on bond notes. The only way they can actually come out with a bond note that will support and back your currency will be based when the break in the system is done and Zimbabwe introduced new bond notes, not based on their currency and not even based on gold. It will have to be based on technology. So they're going to get rid of the bond notes. They're going to still need the United States dollar. Now watch what I'm about to tell you. Guess what's going to happen now. Watch how Donald Trump will make an announcement or a speech and say, Zimbabwe, I've been telling you for all this time to use your own currency. So since you don't want to listen to me, I'm going to remove my dollar out of your country. Watch. It's going to be priceless. And then these people who got rid of the banknotes will have to come out with another dollar, the currency anew, or even restore Zimbabwe dollar based on a real banknote. Watch. It's going to be priceless. It's going to be priceless, people. So they're going to have to come out with the logic to actually, you know, come out with something to say, okay, we got too much higher rates. Let's get rid of 6 zeros. Let's get rid of 9 zeros. They can actually do it if there is a break in the system. Because if there was no break in the system, at the most, they can just get rid of 3 zeros. But there will be a break in the system. And when the break in the system happens, watch as they delete 9 zeros out of that banknote. And when they do, you may actually be able to redeem or exchange. I don't give a fuck how you call it. Okay? You're going to be able to do it if everything happens just like I told you. But nobody's giving a cent out of this investment. I gotta be honest with you. I would not even talk about the Zimbabwe if I have never, ever, ever listened to Emmanuel Makandiwa. If Emmanuel Makandiwa will have never come out with this, I'm telling you right now, I will still call you a retard for having the Zimbabwe. Okay? But nobody can give a cent out of the Zimbabwe. Nobody. There is no banker up there and no investor that will put a dime on your Zimbabwe. But then again, God is going to shock us, right? So let's wait. So let me explain this in Spanish. ¿Qué es lo que dice la noticia acá? Y ahorita te voy a decir lo que va a pasar con Peña Nieto. Me están preguntando aquí de Peña Nieto. Déjame explicarte qué es lo que pasa con la noticia del Zimbabue. Antes de que saliera esta noticia, yo te reporté que en Zimbabue habían dicho que tenían planes para quitar el bono, el dólar zimbabuense y el bono, porque no hay valor en el bono. Yo te lo dije. Mientras todos estos cabrones mentirosos están diciendo que tú vas a cambiar tu Zimbabue por un bono, yo te dije todo el tiempo, no existe ese bono, no existe. Y entonces, una vez más, vengo a probarte que mi información es exactamente bien. ¿Por qué ahora dijeron, pues vamos a quitar del bono? Y yo te vengo diciendo, en la filosofía de las élites, no escuches lo que te digo, mira lo que yo hago. Esa es la filosofía de todas las élites del mundo. No escuches lo que yo te digo, mira lo que yo hago. Esa es la filosofía. ¿Qué es lo que te dijeron ellos? Dijeron que no querían el bono. Después salió el presidente de Zimbabue, el gran salvador de todos ustedes, que es corrupto también, y dijo, no, vamos a mantener el bono. Después dijeron que no y después dijeron que sí. ¿Y ahora qué está saliendo? Está saliendo en la noticia en Zimbabue que se van a deshacer del bono. Entonces, ¿me equivoqué? Yo no me equivoqué. No hay valor en el bono. La única manera que tú vayas a poder cambiar, y te voy a decir una cosa, no hay un inversionista serio que yo conozco que me da la oportunidad, o por lo menos da el beneficio de duda, que este dinero tú lo vayas a cambiar. Si no hubiera sido por el profeta Emmanuel Makandiwa, yo no estuviera hablando del bono. Todavía estuviera insultándote, llamado retrasado mental, porque realmente es muy, pero muy, tomaría un milagro para que tú cambies el Zimbabue. Esa es la verdad. Tomaría realmente un milagro. ahora se van a quitar del bono. Fíjate lo que están haciendo. Se van a quitar del bono. Han abierto cuentas apoyadas por el dólar americano. ¿Ok? Pon mucha atención. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que viene ahora? Lo que viene ahora es que van a inyectar más dólares en Zimbabue. Donald Trump va a hacer un anuncio. Pon mucha atención. Donald Trump va a hacer un anuncio. Y en el anuncio le va a decir así a Zimbabue. Le va a decir, mira, yo le he dicho a ustedes que tienen que usar su propia moneda. Que no usen el dólar. Y yo considero que eso lo está a nosotros dañando. Así que voy a quitar todos los dólares de Zimbabue. Eso es profético. Eso es profético. Cuando pase eso, en Zimbabue van a tener que ser forzados a sacar su propia moneda y no apoyarla con el dólar, no, ni con el oro. Van a tener que sacar un bono que tiene valor y ese bono tendría que ser respaldado por tecnología, no por oro. Tecnología. Y cuando pase, van a tener que todavía sacar un plan para quitar ceros de esa moneda. Cuando pase eso, como va a haber el rompimiento del sistema, van a poder sacarse o borrar más de 6 ceros. Además, hasta yo creo que van a hacerlo con 9 ceros. Cuando pase eso, entonces las chances que tú tendrás para cambiar o vaya, rendir tu dinero son todavía muy mínimas, pero todo puede pasar. Todo puede pasar. ¿Ok? Porque Dios dijo, te voy a sorprender a ti, Benny, y voy a sorprender a todo el mundo. Entonces entiende cómo se está haciendo el proceso. Ahora se van a llenar de dólares y después, mira Donald Trump. Pon atención a todo lo que dice ese viejo gordo color de anaranjado, porque muchos de ustedes lo odian. Y cuando él haga esa introducción o ese discurso, va a decirle directamente a Zimbabue, hey, te dije que no quiero que uses mi dinero, ahora voy a quitar todo mi dinero de Zimbabue. Y cuando pase eso, no va a tener precio. No va a tener precio lo que va a pasar en Zimbabue. ¿Ok? All right, so I hope that I make myself very, very clear. So if you still don't have any doubts, please let me know. I will answer your questions, ¿ok? Now let me bring my sister and Lord, and then I'm gonna call my brother in Christ from Puerto Rico. I'm going to call my brother in Christ from Puerto Rico, and I'm going to show you his anointed message, all right? So hold on, because we're not done yet. We're almost done, but we're not done yet, okay? All right, so hold on. No more question, guys? If you got no more question, let me know. Oh, yes, Peña Nieto. Let me talk about Peña Nieto. That's the president of Mexico. Ahora, les voy a decir una cosa de Peña Nieto. Peña Nieto, el acuerdo que firmó Peña Nieto, porque Peña Nieto empezó el acuerdo con los Estados Unidos. Él es todavía un títere del cabal. Con mucha atención. Como condición de que la nueva élite no lo matara o que no lo pusiera en la cárcel, Peña Nieto acordó colaborar con Donald Trump para este tratado. Pon mucha atención. Entonces, como condición, él lo hizo, pero él no lo quería hacer. ¿Ok? Ahora, con el nuevo presidente de México, mira lo que le va a pasar a Peña Nieto, aunque no lo creas. Porque el acuerdo fue entre la vieja élite y la nueva élite. López Obrador es nueva élite. Y el acuerdo no lo incluyeron a él. Y te recuerdo, López Obrador va a quitar la corrupción allá. Y si tú crees que no le va a pasar nada a Peña Nieto, estás muy equivocado. Eso es todo lo que te quiero decir. So what did I just say? Peña Nieto is the president of Mexico. He signed the agreement with the new elite. Peña Nieto is another one puppet of the cabal. Okay? He didn't want to do it. He attacked viciously Donald Trump. And now all of a sudden he was nice because that's the way it is. Corrupt people, that's the way it is. They attack you. They call you all types of names. They insult you. And all of a sudden, you're a nice guy. Okay? And so, but the agreement was only done between Peña Nieto and the new elite. López Obrador, which is the new president, is new elite. But he did not sign the agreement. He did not sign the agreement. So watch what's going to happen to him. Watch what's going to happen to Peña Nieto. Okay? That's all I got to tell you. López Obrador promised that he was going to get rid of corruption. It's going to be priceless, people. I'll tell you that much. Oh my goodness, my Skype doesn't want to open. Oh my God. Where is my Skype? All right, guys, hold on. Hold on, guys. I'm trying to open my Skype and it doesn't want to open. Oh, God. All right, since I can open my Skype, something's going on with my Skype, has crashed. I'm gonna have to call my guest without my sister, okay? Hold on, guys. Let me call my guest. Let me call my guest right now. And we're gonna, hold on 1 second, okay? Please hold. Okay, hold on, guys. Hold on. I'm having online. Hold on. 1 second. Can you hear me? ¿Me puedes sí. oír? ¿Aló?
Sí. Hello.
Okay.
Dios lo bendiga.
Okay, Dios te bendiga. Hold on. Let me see. Let me make sure that everybody can listen to him. Okay? Okay, hold on. ¿Quieres dar tu primer nombre o no?
Capi.
Tapi. Oh, Capi. Capi. Ok, we're gonna call him Capi, ok. Vamos a llamarle Capi. Vamos a hacer la entrevista en español y voy a traducirlo al inglés. I'm gonna make the obvious reasons. I'm gonna make the interview in Spanish and I'm going to try to introduce it the best way I can. All right, so hold on. Let me just get that. Oh, not this one here. Sorry for that. Hold on.
Okay.
All right. Okay, Capi. ¿Dónde conseguiste yeah. esta información? Where did you find this information?
Bien, bien, bien sencillo. Ven, el Señor nos da a nosotros unas bendiciones especiales y hay un procedimiento en la vida donde tú vas entendiendo cuál es el propósito que Dios te quiere. Okay. Me dio a mí una bendición de yo ver videos, calvar en todo el internet y ir por más de 10 años guardando, viendo, y según tú vas viendo, llega un momento en que tú puedes asimilar una cosa con la otra porque ves un periodo de más de 1,000 videos.
Ok, hola, un momento, déjame traducir más. No te me acerques mucho porque acuérdate que estoy traduciendo, ¿ok? All right, so he said that for 10 years he's been actually saving a lot of prophecies and videos, and because God has been actually guiding him to pull all the pieces together, right? So that's why he brought up this. This is an audio. It's an audio that I'm going to release. And it tells you, like I told you, if you have your Bible, I want you to have your Bible. Because I'm going to tell you what to look into the Bible. I'm sorry, but hold on. Un momento, por favor. Estoy tratando de conectarme con mi hermana en Cristo, la pastora, y no abre mi Skype. My Skype is not opening. It crashed. I'm sorry. I apologize. I may call pastor in a three-way. That's what I think I'm going to do because my Skype is not working. So hold on. Déjame, voy a llamar a mi pastora para que en un three-way para que ella pueda participar en esto, ¿ok? Okay, one second, hold on, guys. Let me call my pastor McCoy. He had the call right here, and let me put it right here. And it says McCoy, hold on. Here it is. All right, let me call her all the way to Canada. All right, hold on.
Karen here. You've reached my personal voicemail.
Yeah, like always,
please,
you never answer your phone.
Message at the sound of the beep, and I'll get back to you as quickly as possible.
Okay, you're not answering the phone.
Five.
Hold on one second. Hold on. I'm going to drop the call again, and I'm going to call back. Hold on. McCoy, you better answer the phone. Thank you. Hold on, guys. All right, hold on. All right, let me call again. Déjeme llamar ahorita. All right.
Hello.
Karen.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Stay in line. Okay. So.
Okay.
All right. So, tú has venido recogiendo toda esta información, ¿verdad?
Eso es así.
Okay. Y en esta información que tú tienes. Hold on. Let me just close the Skype again. En esta información que tú tienes, encontraste este pedazo donde explica. ¿De un puerto en Kurdistán o es en Irak? ¿No sabes el lugar?
En Irak, Irak.
En Irak. Okay, let me explain to you what he found out. He found about a place, a port. Are you listening? A port in Iraq. In the port in Iraq, in the Bible, he explains that when that port is open to the international market, it will be the biggest thing for Iraq. Okay? And I'm going to tell you, I want you to open the Bible. I'm going to tell you straight out what is the place where he says it, that it will go international and it's going to bring a lot of wealth. Okay? All right. Jody, I hope that you find this very interesting. This information is awesome. I'm telling you, man. All right. So, mi hermano. ¿Me puedes decir, por favor, la parte donde dice en la Biblia, según el audio que mandaste, donde habla de este puerto y que al abrirse se va a ir internacional y va a traer bastantes riquezas a Irak?
Sí, voy a mirar.
Okay, he's going to find out about the part in the Bible where you can see it yourself, and he talks about, because it was a prophet who talked about in the audio, okay? It was not him. He just saved the prophecy. I'm going to play the prophecy, okay? I'm going to play the prophecy. But I want you to see for yourself in the Bible. Because when I heard this man, he shocked me. Okay? He shocked me. And let me remind you something. It's been told that in Iraq, we got the, actually, in that place, according to some theologians, heaven on earth started on that place of the world. Okay, heaven on earth. That's I don't know if it is true or not. That's what they say. Have you heard that about it, Karen?
No. No, it does sound familiar, but I can't really honestly confirm.
Okay. All right. So we're going to do some survey. We're actually researching, and he's going to go back and tell me what is the part in the Bible. Let me just play the audio. Déjame tocar ahorita el audio. Déjame tocar el audio, okay?
Sí.
Let me just play the audio that he's talking about. Maybe you guys can hear what I'm talking about. Oh, hold on. So, ¿tú lo pusiste en qué chat?
En Luz, el tuyo.
Oh, Luz Verde. Okay. All right, we're going to go to Luz Verde. We're going to go to Luz Verde chat room. And I'm going to play the audio.
No, yo lo quité. Ya,
¿por
ya
qué
no
lo
está.
Quitaste, hermano?
Ya no está.
¿Por qué lo quitaste?
Pero ven.
¿Ah? ¿Por qué lo quitaste? Hermano. ¿Aló? Hermano, ¿estás ahí? ¿Aló?
Hello.
¿Por qué lo quitaste?
Sí, lo quité porque yo había anunciado anteriormente que iba a dejarlo por un tiempo para que pues ciertas personas pues lo escucharan, entonces pues porque poco a poco yo iba a ir poco a poco, ¿verdad? Poniendo ejemplos para que la gente pues lo escuchara.
Okay, pero no lo hubiera quitado.
Cuestión de la protección de autor. Okay.
Pon, hazme un favor y ponlo otra vez porque necesito tocarlo.
Okay, dame un break.
All right. So I basically what I asked him was to please publish it again in the chat room so I can play it and everybody can listen, okay? Because some of you are not in my chat room, right? So I can play it and everybody can listen. And we're gonna go in actually, you know, use the chapters, the scriptures in the Bible, what he said very clearly. And I was like listening, I was like, what? You know? So déjeme ahorita, vamos a leer, vamos a escuchar el audio. Él lo quitó. Yo no sé por qué lo quitó. Realmente no debería haberlo quitado. Y después de esto, pues vamos a, te voy a enseñar esto. Yo no sé qué, porque muchos de ustedes no están en mi chat. Y quiero que lo escuches. Es muy importante. Como en la Biblia, él lo explica, porque es un profeta. Él lo explica por qué.
Ya debe estar ya.
Ok, ¿ya está? Ok, hold on. Hold on. All right, hold on, let me go. Déjame, voy a ir a buscar. ¿Ya lo metiste en el chat room?
Sí, debe estar ya el último.
No, yo no veo acá. Yo no lo veo. No lo veo.
Ok, lo vendí a otra vez.
¿Lo metiste en Luz Verde?
Sí, Luz Verde.
Ok, yo no lo veo acá. Espérate. Déjame hacerlo otra vez. Hold on, he said that he sent it. I cannot find it. I still cannot find it. No lo veo, ¿no? ¿Estás seguro que lo mandaste?
Ahí lo envío otra vez. Lo envío otra vez.
Ok, porque esto no se está refrescando acá. Hold on, let me go to my computer. Ok, voy a ver a la computadora a ver si me lo mandó o no. Okay. Oh, I got it. Okay.
Sí, I'm gonna aparece ahí.
Okay, ahorita lo voy a tocar. Lo voy a tocar, por favor, ponga mucha atención, ok.
Estudio profético del doctor Alducín con puerto que aún no sé escucharlo. Esto es un pequeño pedacito y usted puede encontrarlo serie número 81, doctor.
Ok, Apocalipsis chapter 81.
Establecerse con el comercio entero próximos. El versículo 9 es de Apocalipsis 8.
Apocalipsis 18.
Dice la Biblia: y los reyes de la tierra que han vivido con ella y han vivido en deleite.
¿Puede ser? ¿Puede ser? ¿Puede ser?
Okay, we're gonna hold it. We're gonna just pause it right now. It is Apocalipsis 18, right? ¿Es Apocalipsis 18? ¿Ezequiel qué? Ok, primeramente es Apocalipsis.
28.
Un momento, hermano.
Revelation, right?
Revelation, ok. Revelation 18, 18, right? Es Apocalipsis 18. ¿Y cuál otro?
Y Ezequiel 27, del 28 hasta el 36.
Ok, Ezequiel. Do you know what's Ezequiel, sister? Ezequiel.
Say that one more time. Ezequiel.
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 Ezequiel. Okay.
Ezequiel 27 all the way to 30. Please watch your Bibles, people. Please. Ezequiel.
I got it.
Yeah. Okay. You got it.
Ezekiel 18,
yes. 23
to
30. No, Ezekiel, ¿Ezequiel qué?
27.
¿Chapter? 27 al 30, ¿no?
Ezequiel 27, de 28 al 36.
Okay, Ezekiel 27, from 28 to 30.
Okay.
All right, now, let me just play it so people can hear it. Maybe they can hear it. We're gonna play it back, okay? All right. Voy a tocarlo ahorita para que lo escuchen.
Oh, yeah. The ships of Tarsus.
Parándose lejos por el temor de su tormento, diciendo, ¡ay! ¡Ay de la gran ciudad Babilonia, la ciudad fuerte! En una hora vino tu juicio. Vemos nosotros claramente la caída de Babilonia. Ya vimos una de las razones que el Espíritu Santo nos da para la caída de esta ciudad religiosa política que en el mundo se va a levantar. Vamos a ver en el libro de Ezequiel, en el Antiguo Testamento, Ezequiel capítulo 27.
27.
¿De qué forma paralela este profeta, casi 600 años antes de Juan escribió Apocalipsis, relataba ya de la misma manera, profetizaba acerca de la ciudad que se convertiría?
Oh my God. Hermano, aléjate del perro, por favor.
Riquezas, mercaderías, tráfico, tus remeros, tus pilotos, tus calafateadores, los agentes. Toda tu compañía que en medio de ti se caerá en el medio de los mares el día de la caída. Descenderán de sus naves todos los que toman remo. Tierra. Y harán todo sobre ti. Todo sobre ti. Traerá.
Hold on one second. Hold on. It's not, people cannot hear. Hold on. Hold on. All right. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just read that the versicle. Can you please read it, Karen? Karen.
Yes.
Read it, please.
Oh, okay, sorry. I was trying to do something here. Okay, Ezekiel 27,
yes.
Verse 28 to 30.
Yes.
The meadowlands shall shake at the sound of the cry of your pilot. All who handle the oar, the mariners and all the pilots of the sea, shall come down from their ships, and they shall stand upon the land. And they shall cause their voice to be heard against you, and shall cry bitterly, and shall cast up the dust upon their heads, and they shall wallow in ashes. That the right one?
Ay, that sounds the same thing. ¿Lo puedes leer tú, hermano? Okay. Okay, lo va a leer mi hermano, porque obviamente ustedes no pueden escuchar el audio. Debido a que viene saliendo de Facebook y es muy malo el audio. Okay, léelo, por favor.
Okay, dice, y los reyes de la tierra que han fornicado con ella y con ella han vivido de deleites llorarán y harán lamentaciones sobre ella cuando vean el humo de su incendio, parándose lejos por el temor de su tormento, diciendo, ¡ay, ay de la gran ciudad de Babilonia, la ciudad fuerte! Porque una hora vino tu juicio.
Okay, so he's talking about
con Ezequiel 27:28 en adelante.
Okay, está hablando de Babilonia. Okay, he's talking about Babylon. Are you listening, Kerry?
Yes, I'm listening.
He's talking about Babylon.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people have been saying that Babylon is the United States.
That's true. They will have.
Okay, but mucha gente ha dicho que la Babilonia está situada en Estados Unidos. ¿Estás ahí, hermano?
Exacto.
Entonces, ¿en qué, cuál es la, qué es lo que dice el hermano aquí, qué es lo que dice el profeta? ¿Por qué dice?
Él está dando una descripción de quién será Babilonia como tal y cómo resurgirá nuevamente. Y se aclara en Ezequiel 27, del versículo 28 al 36, lo aclara específicamente, donde se menciona un puerto que había en el pasado en Irak y decía que iba a ser la entrada y la salida del comercio mundial y llenará a todo el mundo de su comercio. Y eso nunca ocurrió. Eso es una profecía futura que va a llegar pronto.
Okay, what he's saying is that that actually describes Babylon. Are you listening, Karen?
I am.
Okay, so that describes how Babylon used to be. And now it will come back again by opening a port that will open the international marketing and the new Babylon will come out again. So, Ezequiel, ahora por favor quiero que me leas la parte de Ezequiel donde explica esa parte.
Okay, Ezequiel.
He's going to read Ezequiel ¿qué?
27.
Ezequiel 27. He's going to explain and why the poor is in the Bible. All right, hold on. Go ahead. Bye. Dilo. Háblalo. Hermano.
Estoy aquí.
Ok, léelo, okay. Por favor.
Ezequiel 27, del versículo 28, dice, al estrépito de las voces de tus marineros temblarán las costas. Notate que está hablando de mares.
Ajá.
Descenderán de sus naves todos los que toman remeros y todos los pilotos del mar se quedarán en tierra y harán oír voces sobre ti y gritarán amargamente y echarán polvo sobre sus cabezas y se revolcarán en ceniza. Se raerán de ti los cabellos, se ceñirán de cilicio y endecharán de ti endechas amargas con amarguras del alma. Y levantarán sobre ti endechas en sus lamentaciones y endecharán sobre ti diciendo, ¿quién como tú, Tiro, como la destruida en medio del mar? Cuando tus mercaderías salían de las naves, saciaban a muchos pueblos y a los reyes de la tierra enriqueciste de la multitud de tus riquezas y de tu comercio. En el tiempo en que seas quebrantada por los mares, en lo profundo de las aguas tu comercio y toda tu compañía caerán en medio de ti. Todos los moradores de las costas se maravillarán sobre ti y sus reyes temblarán de espanto, desnudarán sus rostros. Los mercaderes en los pueblos silbarán contra ti, vendrás a ser espanto y para siempre dejarás de ser.
Wow. All right, so déjame preguntarte. Acabas de leer Ezequiel
27, versículo 28 al 36.
36, ok. Karen.
Yes.
All right, read Ezequiel 27, dijiste?
27.
27 all the way to 36.
Ezequiel 27, capítulo, versículo 28 al 36.
All right. Okay. Ezequiel 27, versículo 28, all the way to 36.
Exacto.
Let me know when you're ready. Karen?
Yeah.
Are you ready now? Are you ready? Karen? You got it?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Hello.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you.
All right, yep. Talk. Okay, I want you to read the whole thing, please.
From 31 to 36?
No. 27. Okay, hold on. Oh, una vez más, hermano. Es okay. Capítulo qué?
Ezequiel 27.
Okay, hold on. Ezequiel 27.
Versículo del 28 al 36.
Okay, verse 28 all the way to 36.
Okay.
Got it?
The me-
The meadowlands shall shake at the sound of the cry of your pilot. All who handle the oar, the miners, and all the pilots of the sea shall come down from their ships. And they shall stand upon the land, and they shall cause their voice to be heard against you, and shall cry bitterly, and shall cast up the dust upon their heads. They shall wallow in ashes, and also they shall make themselves utterly bald for you, and gird themselves with sackcloth. And they shall weep for you with bitterness of heart and bitter wailing. Also in their wailing they shall take a lament for you, and lament over you, saying, who is like Tyre, like her who is silent and in the midst of the sea? When your waves went out by the sea, you filled many peoples. Wow, tsunami. You enriched the kings of the earth with the multitude of your riches and of your merchandise.
Stop it right there.
Now that you are
stop it right there. Stop it right there. First of all, that scripture is talking about a port. A coast, okay? It's talking about ships. It's talking about a lot of wealth coming from that country, from that place, that have make and bring a lot of wealth to a lot of people. Am I right?
Right.
That's the RB. That's the RB. When they go international, they're going to open that port. And that was prophesied, I don't know how many years ago. What was it, 100 or 1,000 years ago? It was prophesied. And that is going to basically, when that happened, it says right here, they're saying right now, Persia is Iran today. And I said, but it was also considered the Babylon in the old times.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so a port must be open. And when it opens, we'll go international. But that actually will happen after the RB will happen, because it's going to bring a lot of wealth, a lot of money, a lot of commerce all around the world, okay? Because of that port, that is biblical. That's what I understood right now in Spanish. So, de ese lugar, de esa costa, va a salir todas las riquezas y todo el dinero y todo el comercio, porque así lo dice en la Biblia. ¿Estoy correcto? ¿Verdad que sí?
Exacto.
Okay. Interesting, very interesting. ¿Qué más?
Y algo bien importante, Benny. Dios te usó poderosamente en el chat que tú hiciste, porque tú dijiste algo con respecto al mar. Uh-huh. Ahí está la clave. Si están pendientes al chat, yo te voy a enseñar y te voy a reforzar lo que tú dijiste para que veas que esa profecía se va a cumplir. Está científicamente comprobado. Y está en internet. Simplemente yo voy a dar las claves para que las personas lo busquen. Y cuando la gente vea lo que hay ahí, el que es mellado, el que nació no mellado, se le van a caer los dientes. Porque está específicamente. Dios va a terminar su trabajo donde la maldad lo comenzó, en Irak.
Okay, he just said that o tú vas a dar unos códigos para unas más información, dijiste.
Sí. Sí, tienen que estar pendiente al chat.
Okay, in the chat, in the Luz Verde chat, he's going to release some information that will prove that God is going to use whatever was corrupted and bring jubilee, bring wealth, bring blessings, okay? And it will happen in Iraq. And that's what he's telling me. Whatever you have been saying is biblical because you've been right. It's chosen, God has chosen you because you need to, actually, I need to make sure that everybody understand how this will change the new paradigm, right? So, we're seeing this thing happen right now. And, wow, man, this is shocking me, man. Seriously. I don't know what to say. Yo ni sé qué quiero decir ya. Me ha sorprendido mucho. ¿Cómo está utilizando Dios y cambiando el básicamente el paradigma? How God is changing the paradigm, you know? It's changing the paradigm. It's beautiful. Hey, te quiero dar muchas gracias por haber estado en mi show. Y sí, a medida que tú vas sacando esa información, yo la voy a dar a entender en inglés, ¿ok? Muchas gracias.
Okay.
Perfecto. Dios los bendiga a todos.
Thank you. God bless you. And so that was Capi. And he's going to release that information as soon as I get it. Then I will let you know. Okay? I will let you know. So it was very interesting. I'm sorry I could not use Skype, but Skype is crashed. And now they're calling me. And now this guy is not... I'm sorry for that. I'm going to have to hang up on him. and just... I'm going to call him back. Anyway, what else do I have for you guys? You already saw the Zimbabwe. You already saw the things that are happening right now. I talk about how the potential that the Dow Jones, once it hit 27,000, Europe will collapse. I told you about the Zimbabwe, how they're going to remove the bond notes and they're going to fill all the accounts with the United States dollar. That's what they're doing. They're filling all the accounts with the United States dollar. They don't want to bring up their currency, their own currency. And we got to watch out because Donald Trump will make an announcement. Please remember what I'm telling you. Donald Trump will make an announcement. And within that announcement, a lot of people will get really pissed off. And a lot of people will really get very happy. And that announcement was prophesied. And I believe, maybe I'm wrong, I don't know, but I believe it's got to do with the Zimbabwe, not the dinar. And why did I say that? The logic is because if people are going to get really, really, really angry, are the people who did not believe in the Zimbabwe. And a lot of people who are going to be very, very happy is because the people believe in the Zimbabwe. And why he's going to get it so mad? What Donald Trump is going to say about it? He's going to tell Zimbabwe, I told you, I don't want you to use the United States dollar. I want you to use your own currency. And therefore, I found that it's not convenient for my economy for you to use my dollar. So I'm going to remove my United States dollar out of Zimbabwe. That is a prophetic word of Emmanuel Makandiwa. And when that happened, wait for instructions. Wait for instructions. Okay? Did I make myself clear?
Amen.
Okay, did I make myself clear? I hope so, okay? Yo creo que me he hecho muy claro cómo va a seguir esto. La profecía que habla de que el presidente Donald Trump va a hacer un anuncio y que mucha gente se va a enojar y mucha gente se va a alegrar, no es concerniente al dinar, es concerniente al Zimbabwe. La gente que se va a enojar es porque la gente no creyó en el Zimbabwe y la gente que se va a alegrar es porque creyeron en el Zimbabwe, porque creyeron en la palabra profética de Makandiwa, de Emmanuel Makandiwa. ¿Por qué? ¿Qué entonces va a decir el presidente Donald Trump? Le va a decir a Zimbabwe, en pocas palabras, te dije que no usaras el dólar, estás llenando tu cuenta de dólares y estás llenando todo eso en dólares. Yo considero que eso va a dañar mi economía, así que voy a quitar todos los dólares de Zimbabwe y cuando eso pase, van a ser forzados a sacar su propia moneda y vas a ver, eso va a ser caos y pánico. Mucha gente se va a alegrar y mucha gente se va a enojar. Muchas gracias por tu atención. Espero que vaya a sacar otro show. Mañana no voy a poder porque estoy malito, ¿ok? No te voy a decir lo que tengo, pero estoy malito. Creo que tengo malo el nervio ciático. Así que espera. A lo mejor hago un show el miércoles. Y si lo hago, si prefiero hacerlo bilingüe, lo voy a hacer bilingüe. Y si no, pues lo voy a hacer separado. Eso depende. So, guys, I don't know if I'm gonna do a show tomorrow. I really don't. And the reason is because I'm kind of sick. My nerve, my aesthetic nerve is bugging me. So I cannot stand being sitting down all the time. I just received a test from my trader, and he said, I asked him, are you saying that we are not hitting 27,000 yet? He said, not yet. Look at the volume, it's very low. For full push to 27,000. So we need to wait, people. Okay? We need to wait. El comerciante de Perú me acaba de mandar la respuesta porque yo le pregunté, me estás diciendo que no vamos a llegar a 27,000. Y me dijo, todavía no. El volumen está muy poquito, muy bajo, para que llegue a 27,000. Así que tenemos que esperar un poco más, ¿ok? Todavía no creas que va a salir a 27,000. Vamos a tener que esperar un poco más. Y cuando pase eso, probablemente vamos a ver el rompimiento del sistema. So, when we get to hit 27,000, we probably will see the break in the system. Okay? So, we gotta just wait. According to the analysis of my most experienced trader, he's saying, not yet. Look at the volume. It's very low. To full push to 27,000. See the volume before what it did for push higher is not there. So we gotta wait, okay? We gotta wait. Thank you so much, my sister. Thank you so much, my sister. Thank you so much, my sister! I think she left. Oh my God. Oh yeah, she left. I ran out of batteries. Oh my God. Sorry for that. I cannot be controlling everything. I just can't. Sorry for that. I'm stupid. All right. So, guys, I promise I'm going to do a show tomorrow, like I said. But I tell you one thing. If something really interesting happened, you'll see me knocking at your door and said, hey, I'm coming out. Listen to me. Please. All right. In the meantime, I want you to remember that we need to wait for a blessing, not based on fairy tales, not based on lies, not based on gurus. You're not praising Benny. You're not praising the family dragon. You're praising the living God. You're praising Jesus Christ. So we need to be very, very clear on that. You will receive your blessing. You will receive your blessing in God's time. Remember what I'm telling you. And this is the problem that I want to end my show. Please pay attention. I want to end this show with this thing. I always had a problem with the prophetic word when it says, why? Why now? And the problem that I have is because a lot of people will believe that DRB will not happen. Have I contradicted myself? No, I haven't. So how this thing will come out? Watch. I will tell you right now how it will come out. Please pay attention. Le voy a decir ahorita cómo va a salir el caos y pánico. Ponga mucha atención. Before I leave, I'm going to tell you exactly how it will come out. I believe, that when we got the break in the system, the banks will declare themselves broke, okay? I believe that the break in the system is the financial collapse. I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry, okay? So let's assume that it's the financial collapse. I cannot assure you, but let's assume that is the financial collapse. If it is the financial collapse, the banks will declare themselves broke. And once they declare themselves broke, they're going to go for the bail-in. So when that happens, Iraq will revalue. And everybody will say, why? Why now? Why now you guys choose to revalue your currency? I cannot even go to the bank because they are asking for bail-in. I'm gonna lose all my currency. Brother John Nigo, please listen to this. I'm gonna lose all my currency because the banks are bailing in. What am I supposed to do? Because I'm gonna hear a lot of rumors saying they're gonna have to bail in and probably they're not gonna be enough. And it will probably take years until you'll be able to exchange. And no, you cannot even go to exchange to any other country because this will be globally. Okay? This will be wild world globally. Right? So no, even if you go to Iraq, even if you go to Iraq, even if you die stupid to go to a place where there's a lot of anti-Christian people and they can kill you. Even if you believe that nothing's going to happen to you, but probably will, it's up to you. But a lot of people will say, why now? Why you guys are revaluing and I cannot go to the bank because they're going to take my money out. So let's go back to the prophetic word of King Clement. He said, I will be releasing all the resources. And the resources, you can call that is the humanitarian projects. I don't care what it is. What I believe in that little part are resources. A resource is something that is available for somebody to come out and fix the problem. Okay? So what do I think is going to happen? Donald Trump will make an executive order and ask all the banks, stop the bail-in. And when that happens, every single knee will bend and everybody will cry. And all of you will be free. Will be free to stretch your hands and your arms to help the lonely, the hungry, and the poor. Because everybody's going to be witness of the biggest miracle that will happen. That is how you're going to get your blessing. ¿Cómo va a pasar todo esto? Después de que todos los bancos vayan a pedir el rescate interno y nadie vaya a poder ir al banco a cambiar. Todo el mundo va a preguntar ¿por qué ahora que todos los bancos nos están queriendo quitar el dinero, no podemos ir a cambiar? ¿Por qué ahora se le ocurren a subir el precio del dinar? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué ahora? Porque así dijo Dios en la profecía. Y la única manera como tú vas a recibir esta bendición es porque Dios dijo en la palabra profética, voy a liberar todos los recursos. El recurso, tú puedes decir que sea los proyectos humanitarios. No me importa eso. Pero para mí el recurso es algo que tú vas a utilizar antes que... Es algo que tú vas a utilizar cuando lo necesitas. ¿Ok? Eso es recurso para mí. Si es algo que tú vas a necesitar para cuando tú lo necesitas, de la forma que se van a dar las cosas, según yo creo, es así. Donald Trump va a hacer una orden ejecutiva y le va a pedir a todos los bancos que dejen de cobrarles el rescate interno. Cuando pase eso, todos los gurús te dirán, no va a pasar, vamos a tener que esperar años. Vamos a tener que esperar años porque los bancos se van a declarar completamente en quiebra. Y van a haber muchos rumores diciéndole, no va a poder cambiar nadie porque va a tomar años. Porque el dinero que ellos están buscando, el rescate interno, no les va a alcanzar. Ellos van a decir eso. Y cuando pase eso, Donald Trump va a sacar una orden ejecutiva y lo va a liberar a todos. Allí está la liberación de recursos de la palabra profética. Porque cada rodilla de todos los que me están escuchando se va a doblar. porque serás libre, libre para siempre, porque vas a poder extender tus brazos para ayudar al pobre, al hambriento y al solitario. Muchas gracias por oírme. Te veo otro día.